Hey there, detectives. This is Ryan from your Oxygen Forensics Training Team, and I'm here to bring you another fantastic video. In this video, we will discuss advanced analytic workflows using some of the powerful analytic tools included in Oxygen Forensic Detective. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. The digital forensic workflow is an adaptive and user or lab-based process designed to increase the accuracy, processing speed, and analytical enrichment of an investigation. While there are varying software tools available to assist the examiner with their workflow, the overall expediency, ease of use, cost, and system resource burden may often limit the resources the examiner can use at any given time. Advanced Analytics with Oxygen Forensic Detective is an all-in-one analytical processing platform. Adapting the digital forensic workflow to the in-program analytic tools allows for a truly user-specific workflow that leverages powerful AI-driven analytics with system resources to provide the examiner with a time-efficient aggregation of forensic artifacts and a convenient and clear result ready for additional enrichment or report export. Throughout this video, we will cover faces and facial categorization, optical character recognition, and image categorization. While each is an individually powerful analytical tool, any combination of them with the examiner's organic workflow will act as a unique forensic artifact enrichment tool, saving valuable time in any investigation. First, let's take a look at faces and facial categorization. With these unique analytical tools, we're able to categorize human faces from images, as well as provide automatic similarity detection between the various faces found across the images. You'll be able to initiate the facial categorization analytic feature either during the import of a forensic image or after processing has completed. Additionally, you're able to aggregate faces from collages and videos for more advanced face-based searching. Let's jump into Detective and take a look at these features. To begin my workflow, when taking a look at faces, first we need an image to import. For this particular case, I'm going to go ahead and choose an Android physical image. And when I do so, it's going to open up our extraction wizard. This is going to be step one in our workflow when using Oxygen Forensic Detective. We have our standard information here that we're used to seeing, extraction, information about the extraction, our general import settings, selective analysis if we choose to do so. Here is another particular step in our analytical workflow that provides us the opportunity to specify particular applications that we want to use or exclude from our import. We have our nested archives unzip, and then we get into our advanced analytics. Now we see here all my options are turned off at import, and that's what I have set from my global options menu. For now, I want to look at facial recognition. When I turn this on, it says facial recognition at import. So then it's going to run against all images discovered on this particular extraction. It'll run facial recognition against that particular device. If I was to run this, understand it will take a little bit more time for the import to occur, but that upfront analytical processing will be complete. Now, if I choose to import an extraction and not run any of my analytics, it's very easy to get into those analytics and run them. So from my extraction tree pane here, I'll select my extraction, and then we're going to take a look at my analytics sections here. To begin, we're going to start with faces. Now we notice that facial recognition hasn't been run, and now I have the option to run it from two separate places. I could run it from this button here, or our top tab button here. This is just a quick indication saying that this may take some time. And now we're going to let this run and come back to it to view our results. If we notice in the bottom right hand of our window, we have our notification center that indicates how many images will be processed against for facial recognition. Now Now that our processing is completed, we see all of the identified faces from this device, from all the images on this device. We have a four column view here. This is going to be our column one, and it's going to be our filters, which is also based in the categories that faces identifies. Column two is going to be all the individual faces that it pulls from the images. Column three is our identified faces with a similarity rating here. So it says I have one image and this is an 80% or 80.4% chance that this is the same individual from this photo. We have some partial photos as well that it's still getting a high similarity rating for. And then we have our common details pane, and this is going to be column four, and it's going to give us all of the same information here to the left, just in a more condensed column in itself to include our covered files path. Additionally, down here in our column three, if there are any faces that share familiarity with another face found or from another image within this device, that'll display here. So if we have an image that came from a collage, then it's going to pull all of the faces from one particular photo, as we see here. It's going to pull every single one of these faces and provide a similarity rating or a familiarity rating with the one individual photo that is pulled from this image. So we have two primary faces identified in our green boxes here from these photos, and then all of our familiar faces boxed in blue. And this identifies that they come from the same photo, and it's pulling those out of that photo. We have an opportunity to look through those in real time at the bottom of column three. Additionally, as our faces analytics have already been run, we have these identified faces. And now we want to use them as a faces set to run and search against other devices that may be within the same case. So what we can do is select an image. If we right click on that image, we have our familiar Marcus key evidence and add a tag to these items, but we have this add to faces set button. If we do that, it gives us the opportunity to create a new faces set and add any photo that we see after facial categorization has been run. We can add those to this set. So now I can select each face that I would like to add to this set and build a searchable faces set with all of the interesting photos, interesting people that have been pulled out during this particular analytic. Now, if we have a particular face that was Now, if we have a face that was found that may be similar, as we see here, with another face that we can tell is not necessarily the same person, we can choose to view this particular image or face as it was found by right-clicking, view more images of this person. Now it's going to jump us to that individual and show us any additional photos or similarity ratings or identified faces with this particular individual. From here, what we can do is create a report simply based off of the results of our facial categorization. And to do so, we simply click our export button. And now we can create a report of varying types with this specific facial categorization information and results. Next, let's go ahead and take a look at our optical character recognition. Optical character recognition, or OCR, is designed to convert words embedded within images into machine-encoded text. With an Oxygen Forensic Detective, there are 12 searchable languages included with your initial install and a companion OCR language pack available from the customer portal. Let's take a look in Detective at our OCR capabilities. From our device overview page within Detective to locate our OCR analytics, just as with faces, we're going to come to our analytics bar here and select OCR. From here, it's going to already populate all of the images found within this device. We have our familiar three column view with our OCR results pane down here. As we can see, OCR has not been run on this device. We know that because the little T indicator here, text indicator, is grayed out. In order to run OCR against a single image, simply highlight the image and click OCR. And it'll run on just that one icon or image. If I wanted to run it on all of my unanalyzed images, so all of my grayed out images, I would select this option. Or if I wanted to recognize text on the checked images as indicated by our checkboxes here. Of course, we could add as key evidence, we can add tags in our column 3 or a note to any one of these particular items. But when it comes to the OCR capability, let's look at its accuracy, because it will depend on the clarity of the image, the size of the image, the color and contrast within the image as well, in order for the OCR technology to pull out the right kind of text. Yes, there will be some false positives. Yes, there will be some false negatives, right? So this is going to allow us to speed up our manual review and analytics overall, and then take the text that we've run our OCR analytics against and search that against the rest of the device. So if we find some text of interest from an image, we could take that text and search against what we find. Additionally, if we run a text-based search within our searching feature, then you're able to search against the text found within these images as well. The main component of OCR is making any text found within an image searchable. So first, let's take a look at our OCR settings. Of course, we chose not to run it at import, but now we have a bunch of languages to choose from. Here are the 12 we discussed before. So you could choose any one that you know may be present on the device. If you'd like additional languages, of course, you could visit your customer area and download our OCR language pack. You can adjust the image size, so the minimum image size that OCR will run its analytics against. So if I wanted to run it against every single image at the smallest level that I can adjust it to that as well. And of course, this is going to increase the processing time overall because there's more images for it to look against. Additionally, we can adjust some of our pre-processing for improving OCR accuracy by checking adaptive threshold processing and upscale images that are smaller than in a particular pixel size. So again, the lower I make this pixel size, the longer this is going to take, but the more granular this analytic will be. Depending on your timeline or depending on the accuracy with which you're looking for in your OCR analytics, you can adjust these accordingly. So now I want to run OCR against all of my images here. And if we take a look at the bottom of our detective window here, we have a total of 10,555 images to search for text against. So this can take a pretty long amount of time depending on the size of the images that we're looking at and the amount of data that may be found within it. So if there is pages and pages of manuscripts that have been screenshot and put into a device, right, then that may take a lot longer for OCR to identify all the characters within those images and then display them for us. So let's get started. As you see in the bottom right, we have our notification center saying that your OCR is running against the image you chose it to run against. And it runs pretty fast, as we can see. It's jumping and then it'll pause or slow down a little bit when it comes to maybe a more dense image as well. So we're gonna let this go. We're gonna notice that as images are by with text, it's gonna identify and highlight here in blue that, hey, we found text in this image. To show that in real time as it's processing, you can click the little plus arrow here, or plus button here, and it's going to identify us what it believes to be the text of this particular image. Now, if I highlight this here in the top of column 2, it's going to display that image and show in red where that text is coming from. So it says, hey, in this image, this is where I've identified this particular bit of text from this image. Additionally, if we look below, we have our OCR results that's going to give us the same information. But here, if I right-click and want to copy out any of these results, this raw text, I can do so and that then add that into a search. So let's look at some more results. Now, I don't want to have to scroll through 10,000 individual lines, right? So let's just filter by images that text is recognized by clicking our drop-down arrow here, filtering by our status. I'll double click text is recognized and apply this filter. While this is processing, let's say someone hands me a thumb drive with images on it that are scanned documents. And I say, okay, I can run this through OCR in Detective, and I could do it concurrently with this current process running. But first I need to import that in. So to import these raw images that may not be from a device, it's as easy as going back to your Detective home screen. So we'll come here to our memory cards and MTP extractions and select this file system folders import option. This is going to select just the folder that contains the data or the images that we're looking for. So I'll go to where that data is stored, whether it be that thumb drive. I'll select this folder. And now we're going to allow our import wizard to import. Let's take a look at what's been imported. And so we see we have a few images here, and because my options to run OCR at import was not selected, we still have to run our OCR against these images within this file system folder. So I will select all and run OCR. As we can see, it doesn't take too long when there's a much smaller amount of images to process, but we can start viewing those results in real time as the process is running, right? So let's take a look at this envelope that we have here. So I wanna open up the image and see it's a bit grainy, but depending on the clarity within that image of the text found, it'll give us the best result here at the bottom in our OCR results. So as we go through, we see what it's identified, and we can see some of this accuracy here. Now, when we look at these results, all of these fields now have become searchable using our search feature as well. So it's an incredible way to enhance an investigation and to provide more searchable data that may be found within photos that may otherwise not have been found. These are simply tools to help add more data to your investigation, to refine that data, to make it more easily accessible to you as the investigator, as well as more easily presentable and more accurate when it comes to how these results look and how they apply to the case overall. I want to thank everyone for participating in and tuning in to this webinar. For more information, please visit us online, and to test out our powerful analytic tools within your own digital forensic workflows, scan the QR code on screen for a free trial license. Thank you, and come back to see us soon.